There are times, unfortunately, when motorways do need to be closed. Primarily, it's about safety. We want to make sure that not only are we working in a safe environment, but the people that are unfortunately involved in some of these incidents are also kept as safe as possible while we're dealing with them. There are all sorts of reasons we might need to close the motorway, and they start from getting some debris cleared up so that we can make sure that the road runs clear. And it might be something a little bit more serious, so it might be some damaged vehicles, it might be that we've got some injured parties there, or worse, and we need to make sure that we can get them dealt with and get them treated.
So the fire service's role in a major incident on the motorway is usually one of two things. Number one, there is a fire. And number two, probably the more common thing, is that there's somebody trapped or a person's trapped in a vehicle and can't get out and they need that care. So we will turn up to an incident. Usually we'll use a fire engine in a defensive way to try and create a safe space so that we can work safely. That's really important. Then what we do is we then stabilise the vehicle, because the car, depending on what's happened, could be in any position whatsoever. And then we'll then come up with a plan based on those casualties' needs. The primary thing is that casualties' care, the way they are. And that could be absolutely anything from a physical injury to somebody who's in a traumatic situation because they've been in a vehicle that's turned over and over. So we will do everything we can to make sure that that casualty is looked after. Then, of course, what we do is get them out of the vehicle in the best possible way.
We have to wait for the police or the traffic agencies to close the carriageways before we're allowed to land. And I appreciate this has an impact on the public and everybody wants to get to work or they've got somewhere to go to. But I'm not allowed by law to actually land on that carriageway unless in extreme circumstances where life is threatened.
All we can ask for is a bit of patience. We don't close roads unnecessarily. We don't take pleasure in closing roads, and we certainly don't take pleasure in dealing with some of the incidents that require it. We need to make sure that we've got everything that we can get from that scene for our investigative purposes, because we only get one chance. So we need to make sure that we've got everything we need in that first instance, so that we're not inconveniencing people further down the line by having to close the road again.
It can be rather frustrating when the roads are closed and you don't really see any reason why the roads are closed, but rest assured that the emergency services are working on behalf of the patient. Whilst it's inconvenient, I would just ask the members of the public to please be patient and bear in mind that they're the ones who will be returning home to their loved ones.
So the important thing is when you're going past an incident and the fire service are in attendance, bear that in mind. There's somebody trapped in that vehicle. And one of the things that we want you to know is that if you're going past an incident and you're using your film or camera out of that car, not only are you putting yourself in danger in the opposite lane of the motorway carriageway, but you're also potentially taking film or footage of somebody who's in the worst possible place they can be at that precise moment in time.
Please spare a thought. If it's a particularly serious crash especially, and you don't know what it is because you're not dealing with it, the simple fact is I don't think I would like my family to find out that I'd been involved in something through social media. We have a difficult job at times notifying families when accidents happen, especially when they're particularly bad. It makes our job more difficult if upset is caused before we've even got an opportunity to try and speak to them.